What we gonna do, Stone? Man, it's second time this week when it came out here fishing and ended up with nothing. What we gonna bring home to Grandma?
I don't know, Mo, but I'm trying to bring this home over here. So I need a little bit of quiet. Okay?
Hello?
Who are you talking to?
No one, I guess. Hey, Stone, I think I see something over there. It's like a bag or something.
Check for it. And I'll take a look around. Mo, will you hold her up while I cut the rope?
Stone, I don't think I can do that.
You can't hurt her no more than she's already been. It wouldn't be right if we left her here while we go fetch police. Listen, all you gotta do is hold her for a few seconds while I cut the rope. It'll be quick.
You ever done this before, Stone?
Once. For a visiting pastor a few years ago. We barely recognized who he was. But her? I ain't never seen her before. You check her bag?
Yeah, I found her ID. Says her name was Emery Edmonds.
Edmonds? Only Edmonds I know is Shirley and Vance. Could be a granddaughter or a niece even. How about I go to a nearest payphone and see if there's numbers in the book? You mind staying here with her? You know, so no animals to get to her.
All right, just hurry up and come back, Stone, all right?
All right.
Why would you carry something like this? The bluest eye. Well, what color eyes you have? Brown. What's this book about then? Piccola Breedlove? A young black girl prays every day for beauty. She yearns for the blonde hair and blue eyes that she believes will allow her to finally fit in. You never finished it. Look, when you get laid to rest, I'll come and read it to you.
For my dearest friend, I hope this letter finds you well. It's so good to read that you're enjoying your time away. I hope it's everything you want before coming back to the city. I'm down south for a few weeks with my grandfolks to help them make jam and fix up their yard. They live in a sundown town, meaning folks like us shouldn't be out after sundown. But me, well, you know how I can be. There's only so much I can see from a porch. Anyway, during the day, my grandfather cooks strawberries for jam. My grandmother sings while she stains the fence. After a long day of outside work and making jars, I wash my hands with this homemade soap my grandfolks make. I know the last thing you want to hear about is soap, but check it. It is the greatest smell I have ever smelled. Every time warm water hits my hands and that scent comes up, it smells like the third grade when I had no worries. It smells like the color teal, like mango with chile. Like how it feels when I put hair grease on my scalp. Like when I lay next to warm folded laundry. Like when I wake up from a great nap and I rub my feet together and feel charged. It takes me somewhere each time, and it cheers me up. Every time I wash my hands, I get a small revival. I'll bring you some. That and some jam, for sure. All so you can see what I mean and see just how much I care about you. And don't be stingy wherever you are. You better bring me something too. I would hope I'm...
Who are we? What are we?